Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today I will be reviewing for you the Gucci setting powder that comes in this beautiful compact. I've been receiving quite a few questions around how I feel around this powder. I'm gonna jump straight into application first, and then we'll actually compare it next to Kosas, the new Dior powder, and Charlotte Tilbury, and see how this powder stacks up. Now, to apply this powder, I'm going to be using my Wayne Goss brush number 13. So this powder is very similar packaging to the Gucci bronzer. The Gucci bronzer has that beautiful teal, whereas the Gucci powder has that light pink beige color to it. This is what the applicator looks like. You can see it's actually quite thin. I was expecting a better applicator from Gucci, but oh well. I mean, for example, in the Dior packaging, the applicator for Dior is very cushiony, very soft, and quite thick. So I picked up shade 5. Now, I actually checked out this powder in store, and shade 5 seemed to be the best match. None of the shades actually look like it had a nice golden or yellow undertone. Most of the shades either leaned pink or neutral. So this is really the best that I could see working for my skin tone. Okay, so I'm going to apply the Gucci one right here. And I'm also going to be comparing Kosas on the other side, just so you can see how the two powders compare. So I'm just going to pop this right here. You see that? I'm going to take a little bit more and then just apply it to my cheek area. I'm also going to go apply it around my mouth. So you can see it has mattified my skin, but there's still a sheen. It doesn't look overly matte or overly powdered. And I'm just going to apply this to my forehead as well. So nothing there, and then the powder right here. And it looks nice and smoothing without looking too powdery on my forehead as well. Right, now I'm going to apply Kosas on the other side so you can see what that looks like. Now, the Kosas doesn't have an applicator or a mirror, so I'm going to use the same Gucci mirror, but I'll be applying the Kosas. I'll be using the same brush as well, but I'm just going to make sure it's all wiped off. And the shade I have in the Kosas, by the way, I've done a full review video for this, so check that out if you're interested in this powder. This is the shade Cushiony. Have a lot of fallout from my eyeshadow as well, so please ignore that. So this here is the Kosas. I'm gonna pick up some more, apply that around my mouth, and I'm gonna do the same for my forehead. Okay, so we have the Gucci. A lot of shine there. And then we have the Kosas. And the forehead. Right away, you can see which powder is actually more mattifying, the Gucci or the Kosas. The Kosas is more mattifying than the Gucci powder. The Gucci powder has a very hydrating finish. It looks soft on the skin. It really doesn't look like powder. It actually looks very, very skin-like. I thought Kosas was skin-like, but I feel like Gucci is on another level. This is what I called truly skin-like because it doesn't at all look like powder on the skin. Sometimes I feel like I haven't even applied anything on my skin, because it just looks like skin, really. You can see there's a lot of shine. I mean, not a lot of shine, but you can see how there's sort of like a skin-like shine to the skin, whereas the Kosas, we don't really have that. The Kosas looks really beautiful as well. And actually, the Kosas is skin-like, but it's a little bit more mattifying. Whereas the Gucci has a lot more of that natural shine to it. And the same thing goes on my forehead as well. So, how do I feel about the Gucci powder? I think the Gucci powder is beautiful. It really is the most skin-like compact powder I have tried so far. It gives a very hydrated and soft finish to the skin that doesn't look overly powdered or matte. It absolutely doesn't look matte, and it gives a really healthy sheen to the skin. I think this is a powder that's really appropriate for normal to dry skin tones. If you have dry skin and you're looking for a compact powder that you can carry along with you in your purse or your handbag, then I think this will be a beautiful, beautiful powder to carry with you because it performs beautifully. I think that it's a beautiful powder for dry to normal skin tones. You will run into some slight issues if you are combo to oily skin. I definitely don't recommend this for oily skin because as you can see from my skin, it doesn't really mattify. Yes, it adds some powder and a little bit of smoothness, but it really doesn't have any oil control. So I don't recommend this for oily skin types. For combo skin types, you can wear this, but just know that you're gonna have to touch up throughout the day because your skin will release some of those oils and you're gonna wanna put that powder back in. So that is a con with this powder. I don't think it's for everyone. It's really best suited for normal to dry skin types, especially for dry skin. I found that when I apply this around my mouth area, it looks really, really nice because I tend to get some dryness around my mouth area, whereas I'm kind of oily in my cheeks and my forehead. So I do generally prefer more oil control powders for my cheeks and my forehead. However, for my mouth area, I don't want powders that are too dry, and this works really well for that. So if you have combo to oily skin, I'm gonna say probably not the best bet for you, even though I know the packaging is really beautiful, but I'm really being, you know, really blunt here. I don't think this is going to be the best powder for combo to oily skins. For normal to dry skins, absolutely, I think it's a beautiful powder. Another thing that I really like about this powder is that it's not too tinted. So even though it has this slight pink tint, my skin doesn't look pink. It doesn't give me that weird undertone. It actually still looks really, really nice. And so I think the color is fine. It's only very slightly tinted, so it's not gonna put a lot of color on your face. The color also doesn't really build throughout the day. So I've been carrying this around with me and trying this out for the last few days, and I can reapply this powder with the little sponge applicator at the bottom, and I don't see any cakiness. I don't see any buildup of color or product. Let's talk about the Kosas. So I think these are similar because they have that hydrating sort of skin-like finish to the skin. So I think these are comparable. Now, there are pros and cons with both of these. Let's talk about the cons first. So for example, the Kosas powder, it is hard to kind of carry this around with you because one, it doesn't have a mirror, and two, it doesn't have an applicator, which means you're going to be carrying around a mirror with you and potentially a retractable brush to apply this powder throughout the day. Another problem with this powder is that it's quite tinted. So as you reapply throughout the day, you might get more and more of that golden tint. So you have to go a little bit light-handed with this. But I do think that I kind of prefer the Kosas over the Gucci. Now that's because I have combo skin. I find that Kosas can actually mattify my skin better than the Gucci. So the Gucci doesn't really mattify as much. It doesn't really remove those oils from my skin, whereas the Kosas can do that while still looking quite radiant. Another pro for the Kosas is that the color match for me is actually better in the Kosas than in the Gucci. So the Kosas has this beautiful golden powder. You can see how golden that is, and it just works so well right against my skin tone. Whereas the Gucci, it really doesn't have that golden undertone. So if I compare them side by side, you can absolutely see what I mean right here. So from a shade perspective, I do prefer the Kosas, and because I have combination skin, I prefer the Kosas over the Gucci. So if you're thinking about which one should you get, should you get the Kosas, should you get the Gucci, it's really up to you. What is it are you looking for? Are you actually looking for a compact you can take around with you? If you are, the Gucci might be a better option. Now let's compare this to my recent review that I did on the Dior powder. This is the Dior Cushion Loose Setting Powder. If you want to check out the demo for this, check out my review that I did. These two powders are very, very different. They're not the same at all. The Dior has a beautiful finish, but it's far more mattifying than the Gucci. So I recommend the Dior for people who have combo to oily skin types because it really gives you that mattified look to the skin that isn't too heavy or isn't too matte. This is actually very comparable with the Charlotte Tilbury Compact, with the Charlotte Tilbury powder, just because the Charlotte Tilbury can look quite powdery on the skin, whereas I find that the Dior doesn't really do that. It doesn't really look very powdered skin. And I mean, generally compacts will look slightly heavier than loose setting powders on the face anyway. So, you know, the fact that this is a loose powder, it has that benefit going for it. But in terms of comparing these two, it really depends on your skin type. I'm gonna say, if you have combo to oily skin, get the Dior. I think it's a better option for you. It will help you control that oil, whereas the Gucci isn't really going to do that. And of course, when we compare my Charlotte Tilbury powder to the Gucci powder, it's really the same thing. Charlotte Tilbury powder is a really great powder for people who have enlarged pores, who have oily skin. Well, combo to oily skin, the Charlotte Tilbury is an excellent option. But Charlotte Tilbury isn't the best for dry skin because it can be a bit drying. It can also look very, very powdery on the skin. Whereas the Gucci doesn't do that. So if you have dry skin, I think you will really enjoy the Gucci. Charlotte Tilbury, not so much. Now, in terms of the scent, the Gucci is the same scent as the bronzer. And I feel like the scent is a little bit lighter in the powder. The bronzer has a very strong perfume that comes from the compact. However, I'm used to the scent now because I've been using the bronzer, so it doesn't bother me as much, or it actually has less fragrance than the bronzer. I'm not too sure. If you've got both of these products, let me know what do you think. But it's the same scent, and it doesn't attack me, right? So I'm okay with that. So in summary, if you have normal to dry skin, I recommend either the Kosas or the Gucci, depending on what you're looking for. You really don't need both. You don't need both. Unless, of course, you want to use this for when you're at home, whereas you want to take this with you while you're out and about. Yep. That could work. Then if you have combo to oily skin, I recommend either the Dior powder, which is beautiful, or of course my holy grail Charlotte Tilbury powder. Both of these are really good in terms of giving you that smoother skin and kind of like that poreless finish, and they both also do a good job in mattifying the skin. And if you have combo skin, you can actually also really use the Kosas. I feel like Kosas is a really great powder because a lot of different skin types can benefit from it, from combo to normal to dry skin. So let me know, which products are you going to pick up? Do you have any of these powders? Which ones are you enjoying? Let me know in the comment section below. And I hope this video was helpful because I feel like there's been quite a few releases for powders. You definitely don't need all of them. And you know, you can just kind of pick and choose depending on what skin type you have. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button, and I will see you guys in my next video. See ya.